Yes, my dear students, now I want to solve some problems which are based on principle of mathematical induction. So, now I want to recall how to solve the problem applying principle of mathematical induction in the miscellaneous exercise of NCERT chapter 3. So, we have already studied in class 11 that how will you prove any problem by applying mathematical induction. My dear students, first you, whatever the statement is given, you prove it n is equal to 1. And then the result which we have to prove, we consider it is true for n is equal to k. And if anyhow you will prove that it is true for n is equal to k plus 1, then this result will be proved for all the values of n. This problem, the problem involving principle of mathematical induction, is a problem having three steps. I want to recall it again. First you prove it by n is equal to 1. N for natural number is here. Then whatever the result you have to prove, you consider it is true for n is equal to k or n is equal to m. And whatever the result you get in second step, you will apply it to prove the value of n is equal to k plus 1 in step 3. And in this way, you can solve any problem of involving principle of mathematical induction. Now, my dear students, now I want to solve the problem number 3 of miscellaneous exercise of chapter 3. What is in problem number 3? If A is a matrix having the element 3, minus 4, 1, minus 1, then prove that it is true for A to the power n is equal to 1 plus 2n minus 4n, n 1 minus 2n, where n is any positive integer, where n is any positive. My dear students, now this type of problem will be solved by applying principle of mathematical induction. So, I have already discussed the problems which will be solved by principle of mathematical induction, which are in book of NCERT. Now, first, I want to recall, we here consider the value of n is equal to 1, then we get the result. What result we get? We get the result by putting n is equal to 1, we get a is equal to 3 minus 4, 1 minus 4. And we consider this result is true for n is equal to k, then we get a to the power k is equal to 1 plus 2k minus 4k, k 1 minus 2. Now by considering this result is true for a to the power k, now we have to prove it by k plus 1. So k plus 1 can be written as 2k plus 3 minus 4 into k plus 1, k plus 1, 1 minus 2 into k plus 1. Instead of k, we put here k plus 1. And now it will be 2k plus 3 minus 4k minus 4, k plus 1, 1 minus 2k minus 2. So finally, for a to the power k plus 1, we have 2k plus 3 minus 4k minus 4, k plus 1 minus 2k minus 1. Now, by putting the value of a k is equal to 1 plus 2k minus 4k, k is equal to 1 minus 2k, we write left hand side is equal to a k plus 1 is equal to a k into a. This is the value of right hand side. And now after multiplying, 1 plus 2k minus 4k, k 1 minus 2k, 3 minus 4, 1 minus 1. And now we multiply it. And you see, we do the multiplication. R1C1, R1C2, R2C1, R2C2, and finally we get the result. 2k plus 3 is equal to k plus 1. Minus 4k minus 4, minus 2k minus 1. Thus, we conclude that it is true for pk plus 1. Whenever pk is true, this is the condition. In this way, we can solve this problem. Thank you. Thank you very much.